Hello, I'm with Cédric Duszak, and I'd like him to present himself.
Hello, Philippe. Cédric Duszak, Operation Director for Hydro Extrusion in France, heading the four extrusion plants for the group in this perimeter in France.
Marris Consulting is often seen as a particularly experienced in the theory of constraints. It's true that I started working with Eliyahu Goldratt back in the 1980s, and it's never left me since. As sometimes, as would happen with you, we get to working together, and I discover that you too have been passionate about the theory of constraints for a long time. So could you tell me your theory of constraints that predated our meeting up?
I started with the theory of constraints more than 20 years ago in one of my first managing position. I remember my boss at that time gave me a book and told me, I was a young engineer, I said, read that because it will serve you in the future. Right. Just after reading the book, it was obvious that this was my plan. It was not the plan described in the book, it was mine. This was really the problem of my department at that time. And by acting immediately on that the day after with the team, we saw immediately some positive effects in terms of results, financial results, but in terms of stocks, managing the flow. It has also, for me, a big impact at that time on the safety in the plant, because reducing the stocks made a lot more place for safety in our system at that time. But this was the start, and then becoming a plant manager, I kept using the principles of theory of constraint, and always it gave us good results. So I'm a fan of that, not an expert, but at least a fan of that in our industry.
Cédric, we worked on reducing the level of work in progress and stocks in general, reducing lead times, improving flow, and improving delivery performance in aluminium extrusion. Many people would say that the machines, the process of aluminium extrusion are incompatible with very short lead times and make to order and all these sorts of things, and yet you've proven that it's perfectly possible with your Hydro Express offering. Can you tell us about that and how you set it up and how people in your organization are now living with it? Are they convinced that the less work in progress I have, the better I am?
Absolutely. It was a shock for them at the beginning when we decided to empty the plants of any aluminium profiles which were laying there in WIP and also in stock, to reduce to the maximum the lead time between the entrance of the rough aluminium till the profile shipped to the customer. It was a bit problematic for them. It was hurting their habits, but at the end they saw that the fact that reducing the stock allowed them to transfer from one operation to the next one much, much faster than before. They discovered that we were able to supply in less than 2 days, and today in less than 1 day directly to our customers.
It's maybe obvious to people outside this kind of business. The order comes in, and more or less immediately the factory will start producing it, and it'll go through the process very quickly with very few queues, very little time wasted between operations, out to the truck and off to the client. This you obviously pushed people or forced people to do initially, but now it's been working for a while and the results are fantastic. Are they starting to believe it, or do they still think you're mad?
Absolutely. It's our way of living today with this system. We came from a KPI-driven plant with a focus on the most expensive assets of the plan, to only one or two KPIs, which are the OTD and the lead time of the plan. And by doing that, we can offer a lot more service. And as we focus only on the bottleneck of the plan, immediately the rest of the foundation starts to deliver even better results than before when we are focusing on the wrong place of the plan.
So let me just say it again. In these process factories, V plants as I call them, whether it's aluminium or steel or many other kinds of industries, people tend to think that the process makes it impossible to be very reactive and offer, as they do in Hydro Express, work to order and lead times in within a day, going through processes that are intrinsically not flexible, such as heat treatment and these sorts of things. But that's what they've shown. It's given excellent results, not only on the quality of service, but on costs and the quality of the products, and it's multi-dimensional, right?
Working capitals as well.
Absolutely.
Improved, so I only see benefits, in fact.
Does that mean you're going to reduce it further?
I'm sure.
So whatever your level of inventory, there's twice as what it should be, right? So tomorrow, divided by two. Together, we started working on what's in the goal, the theory of constraints applied to manufacturing. We got some wonderful results with you. And because then the credibility of the theory of constraints was increased within your organization, that led to some of your people coming to see you and saying, what about this other thing called critical chain? Can you tell me about that?
Given the results of the first diagnosis that we made together and for sure the improvements that we did in the plants, people started also to read by themselves some papers on the theory of constraint, and they discovered this critical chain, and they came to me to say, okay, we will have an investment now, and maybe it could be good to apply the same principle but for product management. And so we did. So you came back to train, in fact, the project team on the critical chain. Results, I cannot say anything now because the project is still ongoing, and yeah. I'm always a fan of waiting the end line before shouting victory. But I think even now, the team developed themselves a critical chain philosophy that I'm sure it will deliver.
I'm sure it will too, yeah. If you have not read the book, The Goal, highly recommend it. It was written before internet, before many things, and yet most people consider it to be still perfectly pertinent in today's world. Read it. I think you'll be surprised. Thank you.